Hi, welcome back to Waxing On. Monday, and Monday is usually jazz day, and today it's not really about jazz albums, but more about a trumpet player, a studio musician. He's played in every type of group, from British brass bands to orchestras, soundtracks, a lot of soundtracks, and we mentioned him earlier in an episode about James Last. And he was James Last trumpet player and was Derek Watkins. Now at that time, I'd also shown you a James Bond album, Thunderball, soundtrack to that. And I've just recently come into another James Bond soundtrack from the motion picture, Goldfinger. Music by John Barry, Goldfinger theme song, Shirley Bassey. I'm going to say we're probably looking about the mid-60s on this one. I didn't look up the movie credits. Sean Connery's third outing as James Bond and lead trumpet player Derek Watkins. Now, Derek played on all of the James Bond films from Dr. No through, I think his last one might have been Skyfall. So he's got a real history with this orchestra. Now, I could go over the names. I'll just give them to you. I don't know if they'll mean anything without seeing it with the movie. We got the main title, Alpine Drive, Odd Jobs, Pressing Engagement, Bond Back in Action Again, Teasing the Korean, Gassing the Gangsters, an instrumental version of Goldfinger, Dawn Raid on Fort Knox, The Arrival of the Bomb and Countdown, and the end titles is The Death of Goldfinger. Now, unfortunately, on these albums, musicians don't get a lot of credit. And that happens a lot with studio albums. Happens a lot to the studio musicians. We really don't know who's playing on there, other than I've been kind of following Derek Watkins. And if you go to his website, you can find out a lot of information and a lot of the albums he's played on or the groups he's played with, because they don't always list them. But again, if you know what he's playing on, you go back and give a listen to what he does. And just an excellent, excellent lead trumpet player. Another album we talked about a few weeks ago, too, was the music from Chicago. This is the actual Chicago movie soundtrack. Originally, I had a discount bin version of it, and I picked this up. A couple of things are significant. Hey, did you know Chicago was filmed in Toronto? We're right back to Toronto again. Eh? The music for Chicago was recorded in London. Derek Watkins, playing lead trumpet for the orchestra on this one. The vocals recorded at Metalworks Studio in Toronto. So not even recorded at the same time. But Derek again playing lead trumpet on the music for Chicago. So another good chance to hear what he can do and to check out his playing. Two totally different styles of music. James Last, a whole different style. But being a studio musician, you adapt to all those different styles and make them your own. Now, a lot of people maybe don't recognize the name. Check him out on the web. He has a website. He's also a web instrument designer, but he's certainly well known in the music fields. Again, it's London, so more people maybe over that way are more aware of him. But if you check out his discography to see just who he's played with or the albums he's played on, give those a listen, because it's well worth your while to check him out, especially if you're a trumpet player. Check out what this guy's got going on. So that's it for today. Just a couple of quick ones. Some music by Derek Watkins. The two I have is my more recently acquired soundtrack to Goldfinger and the soundtrack to the movie Chicago. Hope everybody's having a good summer. We're into August now. Won't be long. Enjoy it while you can. Till we see you on Wednesday, everybody, take care, stay safe. Thanks for stopping by.